up, guys? Welcome back to Rob Squad Reactions with your boy Jay
and your girl Amber.
We're back today with another video suggested by you guys, our amazing subscribers. Before we get into what we're doing today, hey, make sure if you're new to the channel, you smash that subscribe button and hit the post notification bell, because we drop videos
every single day.
But babe, tell them who we got today.
So today we're listening to Joe Crocker, and the song is "With a Little Help from My Friends."
Joe Crocker with a little help from my friends. I don't think I've ever heard this song before, so I'm super excited to get into it. Have you ever heard it?
No. So this is a new one for me.
It's a new one for both of us. Not a lot of talking today. We're going to go ahead and jump right into this video. Joe Crocker with a little help from my friends. 1969.
Woodstock.
In Woodstock. Let's get it.
Well, we're going to leave you with the usual thing. The only thing I can say, as I've said to many people, and this title just about puts it all into focus. It's called "With a Little Help from My Friends." Remember it.
He's got an accent.
Mm-hmm. Expecting that.
I really liked the sound at the beginning, but I wasn't expecting it to slow down to more.
I wasn't expecting it to be soft like
yeah,
that.
Yeah. But his voice, like, wow.
Wow.
Oh, years that have sang you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Oh, baby, happy back. Tell me what you said no more.
Yeah.
I'm certain it happens all the time. You know it does.
Guys, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for pausing it. These two dudes right here, what are their names? Drop down in the comments, what is this lead singer's name? Because his voice is absolutely...
I think it's Joe Crocker. I mean, I could be wrong.
Crazy.
But it says Joe Crocker, unless Joe Crocker's name in the band. You know, sometimes we do that.
And who is the name of the backup singer? I don't know what you would call it, but that...
His voice is different.
Different. It's like a weird falsetto, but
yeah,
it's good.
But with his gritty, deep, and
then his,
you know, higher, just... Very different. Like, I don't know, somehow they still complement each other.
His grit, like, you know how Janis Joplin's just that grit, that screaming. I feel like he's like kind of, I'm not saying he is, but like, he's kind of like the male Janis Joplin. He does that screaming, just, and it sounds good.
Right, I kind of see what you're
saying.
You
see what I'm saying?
Not on her level.
No.
When you turn out the light, I don't see nothing, but it's just... I gotta get my friends together. Cause all we gotta do is love now.
Playing the imaginary guitar.
I'm gonna take them home with me now. You gotta get over your friends. You gotta get all your friends. Nobody knows the way.
Really fast.
Nobody knows the way. You got your friend. You got your friend. You got your friend. You got your friend. You got your friend.
Oh my God.
You got your friend.
Oh my goodness. Dude is going nuts. This one is tripping.
And myself, thank you almost indeed. See you again. Beautiful.
I wonder where he's from.
Yeah, he does have an
accent. He's got me from like the UK.
Okay.
Alright guys, so Joe Crocker. Wow.
The amount of energy he put into that performance was absolutely outstanding. And I know like at the beginning he was like, it looked like You know, he was moving a little different, you know, but I've said this before. I like that. I like when people are just free and on stage.
Boy was on that psychedelic juices.
But that's okay. Like, he obviously enjoyed it, and that's probably a performance that everybody in the crowd
It probably made his performance better.
Yeah, and I haven't been to Woodstock. I would love to go to Woodstock.
I would too.
I'm such a, like, that would be a dream.
So fun.
But the Woodstock that I kind of, I don't know, but, like, you know, I'm seeing what Woodstock was kind of like in movies and stuff like that from the 1960s and 1970s. Like, I feel like he is the epitome of what you probably would want. Not the epitome, but, you know, something you would definitely want to hear at Woodstock. I think he embodied it really well, just being free and having fun and all that. But I liked it. I liked his voice.
Yeah, his voice was definitely one of a kind. You know, I mentioned, you know, like, we just did Janis Joplin, Ball and Chain, and how she was just kind of free, and she was kind of screaming her lyrics. Like, that's kind of the same thing he did.
It's the same type.
Yeah, it's the same type. It's just like it's kind of that old Southern soul, kind of.
To me, when they sing like that, like, I don't know, if to me, it's just like, it's just free. Yes, I've already said it, but it's just, like, I would love to hear the studio version, because, you know, studio and live versions are very different. But I would love to hear the studio version, but there's something really special to me about live.
I like to hear the artist raw and uncut.
Yeah.
Like, no, nothing else added to their song, just them. But, guys, this is going to be the end of our video. We hope you guys enjoyed it. As we always send you guys out with, we love you, we thank you, we appreciate you, you are blessed. Make somebody smile today, and we'll see y'all later.